Hi friends, you are watching Keratoconus Hub TV. Keratoconus is a degenerative corneal disease caused by thinning of the cornea. So, in case of progressive keratoconus, if preventive measurements are not taken on time, corneal transplant may be required in future. When the corneal thinning approaches to a stage where no other vision correction method or treatment works, corneal transplant may be advised by your eye doctor. Since thinning of the cornea causes further steepening of the cornea, this makes fitting of contact lenses very difficult and wearing them becomes intolerable due to increased corneal cone. In corneal transplant, a diseased or injured portion of the cornea is removed and replaced by a new healthy part of the cornea. This new replacement has to be taken from a cornea donor. Corneal transplanting is also known as corneal grafting. Vision quality after the surgery gradually improves as the eye accepts the new cornea. There are two main types of techniques adopted for cornea transplant in case of keratoconus. First one is penetrating keratoplasty, PK, and the second one is deep anterior lamellar keratoplasty, also known as DALK in short. Risks of corneal transplant. What are the risks? As certain risks are involved with all kinds of surgeries, the corneal transplant too is not any exception. So, here are some risks associated with a corneal transplant. First risk is corneal graft rejection, which is possible in some cases. The second risk is of eye infection. The most severe risk is the corneal graft rejection, in which the eye does not accept the cornea and treats it as a foreign body, so it tries to destroy it. Therefore, it is very much essential to identify the symptoms of corneal transplant rejection. These symptoms are redness, extreme sensitivity to light, decreased vision, and eye pain. Even after cornea transplant, the patient most probably would have to use glasses or contact lenses for functional and satisfactory vision. Hence, it is clear that it is better to diagnose the early symptoms of keratoconus and take preventive treatment like cross-linking to halt its progression. Friends, you can subscribe my channel Keratoconus Hub TV to watch my latest uploaded videos. See you in the next video. Till then, bye-bye.